Liz, thanks for that in-depth report. Why is equipment from the Tesla Gigafactory getting shredded? We first told you about the shredding and surplus equipment last night at 11. And tonight, Two on Your Side, Steve Brown tells us the millions of dollars worth of surplus equipment is actually much higher than we first thought.
The update on this story is over total tax dollars spent on equipment that Tesla does not want in its South Buffalo factory. We kept coming up with a different dollar amount than the state agency New York creates. So we shared our documentation, the agency shared theirs, and we've concluded the agency is right, and it's really not good news for them.
We can report state government is in the midst of trying to unload $207 million of solar panel manufacturing equipment purchased for what was originally referred to as the River Bend Project. This was the cornerstone of what was then Governor Andrew Cuomo's Buffalo Billion Initiative. The plan then was the giant 1.2 million square foot facility was to become the largest solar panel manufacturing facility in the Western Hemisphere. Elon Musk, co-founder and leader of Tesla, wanted instead to make solar roofing tiles. A change in product at the factory meant a change in equipment, and a space crunch quickly developed. Tesla complained the still crated and unused equipment for solar panel making was crowding the floor where the roofing tile production line was being assembled. So state government checked off on moving some of the equipment to this Wheatfield warehouse complex where it sat until recently. In the last few weeks, trucks from Ed Arnold Scrap Processing in Corfu have been making runs to pick up unwanted machinery at both the Wheatfield warehouse and the Tesla factory. New York Creates acknowledges $22 million worth of idle equipment has been scrapped so far. The rest? A spokesman tells Two on Your Side, we are currently in the process of remarketing tools and equipment in an effort to sell them for the highest possible price.
New York Creates has not fully disclosed what it's gotten for the equipment it has already sold. The reason, the spokesman explains, is to protect the state's interests in ongoing negotiations with companies interested in the unwanted machinery. But the agency has only provided two options to us as it tries to unload $207 million worth of taxpayer-financed equipment. Either it gets sold or it gets scrapped. Steve Brown, Channel 2 News.